Hi, this is Ask Patrick series. The question is by Epic 7. The question, how do I approach a double negative sum in the exam? So if you look at the double negative sums, they're normally quite common as far as reading comprehensions are concerned. It is there maybe in mathematics and other areas also. So what is the double negative question? So normally you have a no in the question. A double negative is there are no two no's. And normally what happens when there are two no's, it becomes cancels each other and becomes a yes. That apart, what I normally do, and this is what happened. I mean, when I came across double negative sums initially, I used to always go wrong. Because in a hurry in the CAT exam, when you're in that space, you tend to read fast. You see one negative, you mark accordingly and go ahead. And that creates confusion. Whenever you come across a double negative sum, even a single negative, okay, try to read the question again, specifically the last part of the question where they've given this double negative question. Read it again and try to understand it properly before you mark the answer. Okay, read it third time if required. Only that one line you have to read it twice. It will not take you too much time. But ensure that you have made a correct understanding of sum. The biggest mistake that happens in a double negative question is that we mark it wrong purely because we are in a hurry to mark the answer and therefore we read only one negative and then go wrong. Whenever you see a negative in your question, some no, not, etc., ensure that you read it properly. Possibly it could be a double negative sum. And then try to understand it, because understanding a double negative sum is not very simple. You need to actually understand what the double negative mean and accordingly cancel out each other. But that is only possible if you read it correctly. So then read it correctly, try to understand it, and then try to solve it. A good way is go to the past CAT papers, see the questions that have come in double negative, and try to understand how it is framed. The moment you understand how it is framed, you will basically understand, you know, the language of double negative, and that will help you to understand the question in a better way. Right? I hope that helps in your query with regards to double negative. It is a problem with everyone. There's no standard answers, but it is a concept of language which is there. As long as you understand the language, I'm sure you'll be able to understand the question itself. Thank you.